already, this is our December monthly meeting, and it is December 19th, 2023. The first item on the agenda is the public comment period. Kim, did anybody sign up?
No, ma'am.
Okay, no speaker signed up for this morning. Next item is a review and approval of the meeting minutes for our November 17th meeting.
Move to approve.
Second.
Got a motion from Mr. Brunke and a second from Mr. Franklin. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. That motion carries. Great. Next item is the VBDA bylaws. Oh, sorry, I missed the financials. Review and approval of the financial statements for November. We've got Blake Huffman with us this morning.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning, Madam Chair.
Good morning, Board Member.
Blake is not Katrina.
I can see that, I hope.
Anybody who's watching at home. Good morning, Blake.
Good morning, everyone. Starting with this presentation, this is going to look a lot like it has last, at least three-ish years. But going forward, we're going to make some minor changes to it. Well, we're going to start off with the operating cash, starting at $4.3 million. The slide's going to look, this is the receipt slide. It's going to look a lot like the expenses slide following. At $1.2 million, Atlantic Park Entertainment Venue to Venture Waves. This is construction in progress on VBDA's balance sheet. $1.3 million in off-site infrastructure at the Atlantic Park project. $425,000 corporate landing business park off-site infrastructure that would be reimbursed by the city. Corporate landing stormwater construction for $22,000, also reimbursed by the city. This next one should say Innovation Park. Sewer construction design for $16,000, and that was reimbursed by the GOVA grant. And $21,000 in interest income with total cash receipts of $3 million. Like I said, this looks a lot like the last slide, the $1.2 in Atlantic Park entertainment costs, $1.3 in off-site work, $110,575 Atlantic Park construction professional services for the month of October. Can you all hear me okay?
Yes. Yes.
$29,000 Innovation Park infrastructure to be reimbursed. I should say reimbursed. And then 2 months of conduit management paid to Global Links. Final cost, $22,734. Administrative services for Corporate Landing Business Park. That was reimbursed in the same month as well. Ending cash, $4.1, roughly $4.2, close to where we began. The incentive and initiative account summary, this includes the EDIP cash and the various incentive programs. This one's going to have some slight changes starting next month. That $2.9 million starting isn't really representative of the EDIP cash that we have, so we're going to break that out. There's no cash receipts, which is pretty typical for these funds at this time of year. Cash disbursement detail of $78,000 includes the monthly lease payment of the bioaccelerator, $10,000 in a facade improvement grant to Assisi, I apologize if I say that incorrectly, Assisi Medical Services, and the final EDIP Part A payment grant to Valkyrie Enterprises for $57,500, leaving the ending cash, which is mostly initiative funds, at $2.8. And this breaks down a little bit, goes more deeply into the EDIP available funds, and pretty much the only difference from the prior month is the $167,000 new grant approved to DOMA. Hopefully that final $3 million will go down once more today.
All right.
That concludes everything. Any questions?
Any questions for Blake?
Thank you.
All right. You got the all clear from Bill.
All right.
Thank you so much. Next item is the VBDA bylaws. As most of you know, a group, actually a very small group of Bill and Mike, have been working on some changes to our bylaws, and I think Alex is going to highlight those.
The bylaws is incredibly simple. It's the EDIP policy that's had the small group.
Oh, yeah. Got it. The bylaws, we were just talking about the changing the regular meeting date. This came up at our last meeting, and it would require a change to our bylaws, and I think the proposal is to move it from the third Tuesday at 8:30 to the second Tuesday at 8:30.
And then the question for discussion for the group is, when do we start? You guys want to start next month? You want to start July 1st? Don't want to screw up anybody's schedule.
I know Bill had some thoughts.
Yeah, I'll keep my own personal thoughts are really related to my professional obligations. But this was brought up by a member of council, particularly their workload on the third Tuesdays. And I think doing that beginning in January would be helpful to our council members, as opposed to waiting till we get all the way through another budget season and then doing it in July. So for me personally, in accommodating the request of our council members here, I would think January 1st would be good.
I don't think that's a problem, except there's going to be some people that made arrangements already for, you have to be aware of that.
You're right. I'm going to look on my calendar.
I'm all in. It's just almost the first three.
I won't be here February and April. But that's fine.
Yeah, don't worry about me. But
you said the first three?
I have obligations.
Yeah, February and April.
Maybe you could make it retroactive and start.
Yes.
Watch your system.
You wouldn't mind that?
No.
It doesn't matter to me. We can start January. Don't hold me just because I'm not going to be here.
You want to start in June?
That's fine. We've got so many people.
Yeah. It gives everybody a chance to adjust their calendars because people have big plans. And
Right. Are you okay with June though, as mayor?
Yeah. I am grateful for y'all to do it at all. Thank you.
And is that the best one? Is the second the best? Is it the first or fourth? Or?
Well, we're trying to get it away from the days that we have an evening meeting. Because it can be an extraordinary
one. Rosemary, if we do it in January, people have already got schedules. Do they get a break for missing the meetings?
I think it sounds like she's okay with us waiting until June time period, so folks that have plans already, we wouldn't end up with a situation, because I'd hate to end up with a situation where we don't have a quorum at a meeting just because we've adjusted the time. And like Mike said, everybody's got it on their calendar sort of pre-programmed.
Yeah.
And that gets you through tax season?
Yeah, just 1 year. It's fine.
Well, I can't get you through the rest of the year. So.
Yeah, no, I mentioned I'd rather start earlier. But
yeah, Bill wanted an earlier start time.
In the morning?
Yeah, I'm a hard no on that.
Motion to deny.
Yeah, it's okay for 8 o'clock.
Still the hard one. So our fiscal year starts July 1. Why don't we just make it effective July 1?
Yeah, is that good for you?
Sounds like an accountant to me.
Yes. It is nice and clean, though, if we started on July 1.
Okay. Thank you for doing it.
Everybody support that?
Yeah.
Any comments on, so starting with our fiscal year July 1, the motion is to amend our bylaws to change our meeting to the second Tuesday of the month at 8:30 in the morning.
Discussion. Is the second Tuesday enough time to have the financial information prepared? Is the second Tuesday at times will be
right? Yeah, we discussed that. I think we're going to be okay as far as this presentation.
Yeah, we did discuss that. So. Okay. And then the chair will entertain a motion on that amendment to the bylaws.
Thank you. Motion to amend.
Motion for Mr. Franklin and a second for Richard. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. That motion carries. Wonderful. Next item is an EDIP policy update. And this is something that Bill and Mike have been working on. And our interim director is going to discuss that.
Well, good morning, everybody. Good morning, Vice Mayor. Councilman Bellucci, members of the
staff. You just gave us an upgrade.
Yes. Basically, the EDIP program is something we wanted to bring in more in line with the state. And so we've made some adjustments to it, as well as take into consideration some of the desired changes, in particular to the average wage levels of the programs that we incent. So what we thought we would do, and Alex, you can add any comments to it, but we would give you a month to consider and take a look at the suggested changes to the EDIP program, but the intent behind it was to both raise the average wage levels of those programs that we would incent on a two-tier basis, and then also bring it more in line with the Commonwealth of Virginia's incentive program. Alex, is there anything we
need? The one thing in particular, there are occasionally situations where the Commonwealth is making an award and there's a performance period that's longer than what we have, and so we have put language in here to allow in that circumstance. So if there's a COF award that is 5 years payback, we don't have to go to council and do all sorts of stuff, or we don't have to ask you guys to amend an award. So we're going to allow that to be considered. It would be reflected in the resolution. So it's going to be done publicly, but just seemed to be easier. We tried to sync up, and you'll see in the black line, we tried to sync up some definitions, two definitions used by the state about qualifying jobs and that sort of thing. And then our liaisons worked with us in coming up with job levels as opposed to just 30,000, 50,000. We're now trying to tie it to the average annual wage in Virginia Beach, which will allow us to stay more current and also raising the floor rather than
Bill or Mike, did you have any comments on the thought process behind the? Well, first of all, I think the important thing is adjusting the floor so that it's tied to what the state and the average on an annual basis. That'll get continually adjusted, which we do not have currently. I know that's been a concern. And then, obviously, we're trying to raise the floor on the minimum average wages, where we're incentivizing folks to either expand or bring new jobs to our area.
And so what we thought we would do is give all of you black line copies of the policy a month. If there's any questions, you want to either call me, call Chuck, want to set up a meeting, that's great too. And then we can discuss it at our January meeting if you guys adopt a resolution recommending the new policy, but then take it to council. So it'd be effective probably in February.
Does everybody understand the process?
Question.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Ron.
Bill and Mike, I know SWAM is a credit criteria for EDIP. And I completely agree with raising, the incentive for what we're paying people for these organizations. I'm concerned about who we would cut off when we start raising it, because some of those organizations that are applying might not be able to compete, and I'm worried about what that demographic looks like. All of a sudden, it's going to take a shift when some of these companies say, "Hey, we're SWAM and we can't compete now." So what do we do? So what is that? What do those numbers look like when we make that adjustment?
I have to say that's not something that we considered when having this discussion. I was primarily focused on adjusting from where we were. Where we were was barely above the minimum wage that the city pays employees, and I used the term several times. This is an incentive, not a subsidy. So we were focused primarily on that and used the VDC. I think that's something that should be vetted a little bit more. It's not something that's
Madam Chair, if I might, we are in fact looking into a grant program specific to small businesses at lower levels so that we could take that into account so that we can make sure that the opportunities that we have for small businesses is taken note of and that we do have some funding for it. So we've made a request and we're going to be taking on working with Eason Malak on a very specific program specific to that.
And Chuck, if we did that, then it would be its own EDIP, it'd be its own section in the program, right?
Sort of a standalone policy or addition to the EDIP. It'd be a different process.
Or just a different section. And I mean, we could put a different category in the EDIP grants and have this.
We could do it that way. And so, as everybody knows, we're going through our budget cycle right now, and we're looking into fueling that with some funding, and I'm hopeful that we'll be able to do that program. And I would very much like it to be a grant, not a loan program. I don't want to be a lender of last resort.
Okay. Okay, good, good question, good comments. Any other questions or comments? I think it's good to give everybody a month to sort of read through everything, get comfortable with it, ask either Chuck or Alex any questions that you have, and then we'll have something next month that we're ready to take a vote on. And like Alex said, our any of those changes would have to go to council then for approval. So I would think we could do it in the same day. Come to us in January and then go to council on the same same day.
The only hook with that is if any changes are made here in the morning, we will already have the council stuff done.
So get your changes to Alex in advance. All right, good. Hearing no other questions on the EDIP policy changes, we'll go to the Corporate Landing Business Park, a request for approval of a resolution authorizing the extension of the terminal lease for Global Links.
Yes, ma'am. This, as you recall, we leased a portion of your conduit, which just runs along Corporate Landing to Global Links in October. It was a 20-year term with 1 5-year renewal. Since then, Global Links has what they identified a potential client who needs a 20-year term with 3 5-year renewals. All the other terms would remain the same. There are escalators for the extra terms, and we have a clause in the agreement that says if they have not begun utilizing the conduit within 10 years, we can terminate. So none of that changes. We're just adding 2 5-year terms at the mutual option of the parties. We ask your approval.
Okay. I noticed the disclosure says legal services Walcott Rivers. I thought it was
for different elements he's using for, but for this he's using for the expense office
government. Gotcha. All right. Any comments or questions on that change? So this helps them line up with a potential tenant of theirs. No questions. I'll go ahead and request a motion on the approval of a resolution authorizing extending the term of the lease with Global Links Data Center LLC for a portion of the authority's corporate landing conduit system.
Second.
Go ahead with Bill this time. A motion from Bill and a second from Taylor. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. That motion carries. Great. Administrative items. Any comments from commissioners? I think David Weiner had a comment for us.
Just wanted to say one thing. I wanted to make sure everybody was aware of what our Parks and Recs Committee department has accomplished. They accomplished a gold medal award for not the statewide, but the whole country as the number one Parks and Recs in the country. And it's very, very, they do a lot of hard work. And just to make sure everybody's aware of that. It's very, very nice to have that happen to us.
Very impressive, and I don't know if anybody saw in the paper, just got, funding for the trail system. That's gonna be huge. Part of that will go here through town center.
From the city line to town center, and it'll include the Ped Bridge. So it's for one segment.
Yes. Which is impressive. That'll help with Parks and Rec and keeping us at the number one spot, hopefully. Very exciting. Any other comments from the commissioners? It's a great time to be in Virginia Beach. Any comments from our interim director?
Well, I'd just like to say that that is an area that we think that from Newtown down here to the town center, there's an area of really real opportunities for redevelopment. So we have been looking at the properties in that area. So this grant, $14.9 million, as announced by Senator Kaine and Senator Warner, is a real shot in the arm to us getting going on this thing. And where we've seen these in the past in the country, there's real opportunities for development and enhancement to the entirety of the city and our citizens' experience here in Virginia Beach. So it's really great news. So.
And this is the former Norfolk Southern right away that the city
acquired.
That's great. And I know planning
has been planning for years now that this would hopefully be something that gets funded, and then we'll have the funding for that. That's great. All right. I wanted to wish everybody happy holidays. Enjoy the time with family and friends. It's one of the nicest times of the year. I just wish it wasn't July and not December. All right. And with that, you know what, nothing else really good with the group?
Okay,
all right.
Madam Chair.
Do you want to know, you want me to?
There.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, it's not on our agenda.
So it's really happy to report that Vanguard Landing has sent us $1.2 million.
And Terra sent us $1.2 million.
It's closed.
So
it is closing today. We have the chair's signature on two documents. We have the money already, which is kind of the important part. They performed. They're saying they're about to close with Virginia Housing. And if they can get their plan approved, off they go.
Well, that's not our problem.
Yes, ma'am. We're done. So we don't have to talk about this here anymore.
Yeah. So to clarify, Centerra has wired us $1.2 million to acquire the note that we were holding that was secured by collateral of the property that Vanguard Landing owned, which is good news. So Centerra will be now their lender.
Correct.
And that will be the end of that. Their deadline is the end of this month, so that's great.
It's really good. I know that you all have been working on that for quite some time, and thank you, Alex, for all the hard work on that. That's great.
Anything else?
Sure. A couple other quick things around.
Sorry, I almost cut you off.
First of all, that's really great news, and the other piece of good news is certainly that you know, the Why Not Pizza property is now complete, and we do own that 14 acres again with the understanding that there's a two-year period of time for which there can be 4.3 acres repurchased. And so I think it was the end of a really good amount of negotiations and discussions that I want to again thank Alex for the amount of work he did, as to that date. So really good news. And that 10 acres is already getting a lot of action. We've got several people that are looking at it. So it really was, I think, the best of a bad situation, right? So really happy. And I really do hope that we have an opportunity in the future to do some business together with Why Not moving their corporate headquarters there. It was always something we all wanted to see happen. And hopefully it will. So if you might recall that they had the opportunity to build one building there that would include the headquarters and additional staff space as well. So over the next few years, we'll take a look at it, and hopefully something good will come out of that as well. I do want to note, we do have a new addition to the development department team here. We've got Charlotte Isabella Chalk. I had arrived, I guess, a couple weeks back. I'm happy to report that Laura is now only 8 weeks away from returning, so Laura, you know, we want you back, and baby's doing great, and mom and dad is a father, too.
She's an honorary member. We don't make anybody that young work.
I'd also like to note that we have a new employee starting on the 4th of January that will be working with Sam Moak at the Hive, Henry Cobb, who has an extensive experience, not only having been a part of the City of Virginia Beach years ago, but also the Iowa Community College, has a great background in small business, and is really going to be a big help to us here at the Hive. So he begins on the 4th. Let's see, I do have to report that Shai Kim is going to be leaving us for her last meeting. Her partner has an opportunity to be taking a career advancement move in Bethesda, Maryland. So I do want to say in the short amount of time in here that you've been terrific to work with. And thank you very much for everything you've done. And Elizabeth, the So we said it sounded like the Godfather, but just as she gets out, we put her back in. She is going to be stepping back into that role for us for a little bit of time, and then we'll move quickly to find a replacement for Shannon. And again, I think you all had an opportunity to see that Blake Huffman is going to be taking over responsibilities for providing us financial information. Been with the city 5 years?
About five years.
And he had served in this role a few years back. And so it's really great to have him coming in. And he's kind of taken a look, as he said, is going to tweak a little bit of the way that the reporting is done. And so it's really appreciative that you're over here helping us out as well. We also have two vacancies that we are currently looking at filling, and so you'll be hopefully being able to hear more about that in the next meeting or two. So it's been very busy, and 2024 with some really exciting projects. So that's my report.
Thank you. All right, and thank you to Kim, and we were just at the point, I think, where we could say your name. You're welcome to come back.
Thank you.
You might find that it's nicer here than it is in Bethesda.
I am going to miss it here, and I have enjoyed my role in this position. Everyone has been super helpful, and I am very appreciative that I was able to help everyone. So thank you.
And thank you to Elizabeth for agreeing to come back and step in. All right. Anything else?
Got to go to the group.
All right. We're good. Okay. Sorry, I'm trying to rush us along to the holidays. All right. With that, then, the chair will entertain a motion to recess into a closed session pursuant to the exemptions from open meetings allowed by Section 2.2-3711A, Code of Virginia, as amended for the following purposes. One, prospective business or industry. Discussion concerning a prospective business or industry or the expansion of an existing business or industry where no previous announcement has been made of the business or industry's interest in locating or expanding its facilities in the community pursuant to Virginia Code Section 2.2-3711A5, and that pertains to districts 3 and 4. And two, publicly held property. Discussion or consideration of the acquisition of real property for a public purpose or of the disposition of publicly held real property where discussion in an open meeting would adversely affect the bargaining position or negotiating strategy of the public body pursuant to Virginia Code Section 2.2-3711A3, and that pertains to districts 3 and 5.
So moved.
Got a motion from Mr. Brunke and a second from Linda, and a roll call vote.
William Brown?
Yes.
William Brunke?
Yes.
Taylor Franklin?
Yes.
Linda Harris Bright?
Yes.
Katie Morgan?
Yes.
Lisa Murphy?
Yes.
Ronnie Parker?
Yes.
Mike Standing?
Yes.
David Weiner?
Yes.
Luther Wesson?
Yes.
All right, we are adjourned.